I've been getting a lot of requests to recommend more songs, more Asian songs, and different types of songs. One of the most memorable requests that I've gotten, several people have requested, is to do like some of the saddest rap songs, Asian songs that I've ever come across with, and I'll do that. But another popular request is to do like a Filipino, sorry, saddest Asian songs that I've ever listened to. But instead of doing a simple list, I will actually do something better and use this opportunity to introduce to you some of the songs, some of the saddest songs I've ever listened to, and also the songwriters that created the songs. So this first one is from the Philippines, by Rico Blanco. The title of the song is Huwag Mong Aaminin, and the literal translation of that is Don't Admit It. Okay, let's get to it. Okay, this scene is just to establish the theme of the song. And the guy asks her to be, are you still happy? And then the title of the song is Don't Admit It. So you kind of know where this is leading to. It's the guy asking the girl, don't tell me the truth. Lie to me. Because he knows that he will not like the answer. Okay. If you love guitars, if you love playing the guitar, this is a great riff. Yeah, so please lie to me. Okay, sorry, but third line and I need to stop. So the number one, the riff is so beautiful. As I've said, if you like playing the guitar, this is an easy but beautiful riff. So this, it only goes to show how great of a songwriter and composer he is, that he doesn't need all those complicated whatever to make something beautiful. And as I've said, I've always remained that I think if you can play a song with nothing but the vocals and the guitar and it's still beautiful, then you know that the song is beautiful. And this he proved here, because he had nothing but the guitar and his voice and those beautiful words and such beautiful emotion, and you know that the song is great. Next is the literal, I've tried to translate the song in a contextual way. So for example, Huwag Mong Aaminin actually in literal translation means don't admit it. But I think you can better capture the emotion by saying something else in English. The Filipino language is so emotional that it's so hard to fully capture the meaning of a single sentence. So, but I tried my best. If you translate it literally, it won't always work. So I tried to contextualize everything. Okay. So, and this scene, by the way, is so relatable to everybody. How many of us would always turn to food, right, when we're lonely and we're sad? And that's what she's doing. And then there's a payoff in the end. He used some popular actors in this song. Sorry, my dog. This is one of the most beautiful and painful lines I've ever listened to. As I've mentioned, the Filipino language is so beautiful and so different. It's so emotional that there's so many ways you can interpret a single word. You can use a single word in one way and it'll mean different and it will feel different, and use it another, the same word in another way and it will mean different and feel different. So the word windang is usually used jokingly, like nawiwindang na ako, it means I'm going crazy. But in this song because he delivered it differently and in a different context, it becomes such a powerful and miserable word. So he's saying, I'd rather sink into the madness of nothingness, the madness of chaos, the madness of nothing, rather than face the thought of losing you. It's absolutely one of the saddest lines I've ever heard in my life. And also such a beautiful way on how he transformed the word from something funny to something deep and painful. Okay. Also, this scene here is even more painful for me because it involves two old people. Because you always think, like, once you grow old, you kind of just let it, right? You're just gonna stay together, you know, even if there's no romance anymore. But, and this is another painful line. If it's okay, it's not so much to ask. It's like this it's coming line. Could you just give this one to me, please? Please do this for me. Please do this for me. He's like, he's asking, can you just do me a solid and lie? And I think anytime you ask somebody to lie to you, even though you already know the truth, I think there's something so miserable and so painful there. So when I heard this line, it's just, wow, so painful. Okay, and then that scene, as I was saying, because it involves two old people, I've always thought that, you know, or many of us maybe would we have this impression that once you grow old, when you see old people, you kind of feel like maybe there's no romance anymore, but if there's companionship, that's fine. But then you see here in this situation, why are you breaking up? You're two old people, just come on, live your entire life together. So so that line in the song, he's saying, "Wag mong aminin, don't admit it," but I translated it as "don't let me know" because I feel like that better captures what he's trying to say. Like, if love is leaving me, if it's walking out the door, don't let me know. Don't let me know about it. So it's not like don't admit it, but don't let me know. I don't want to know if it's leaving, it's walking out the door. And this specific scene where she finally breaks down, because in the beginning she was put in this sort of almost comedic state of her eating, trying to look for food to fill her emptiness. And then finally she breaks down. And you would think that this kind of cry would be comical, but because you kind of feel the song, you know the emotional turbulence that she's experiencing. It was extra sad for me. I think this was like, for me, it was the breaking part when she finally gave in. She's such a simple, beautiful woman, and she was totally hopeless with love walking away from her. And this is also painful when you're just, I'm leaving. And you're like, come on, just live your life together forever. And then in the end, she lies. She will lie, of course. Okay. So there's beauty in the simplicity of the song, and I think that's what I appreciated about it. He did not, as I've said, he did not embellish it with a lot of things. It was just that's his genre. So he had the guitar, the bass, drums, and that's all he needed to make the song beautiful. As I've said in the beginning, I still stand that if you can play a song with nothing but a guitar and a vocalist and it's still beautiful, it means the song is beautiful. And that's what he proved, that he can do that. In the riff in the beginning, he could have sustained this entire song with nothing but a guitar and it would still be beautiful. there's nothing complicated about the poetry of the lyrics, and that's also what I appreciated towards it. It felt like he was just talking. It was like a conversation between one person to another in an everyday life. There was nothing, there's no embellishment, there's no Shakespearean kind of poetry. It was pretty straightforward. The only metaphor that he used was the knife. Don't stab me with the knife I know that you're holding, which was a metaphor for the truth about her not loving him anymore. But other than that, the rest of the time, it was pretty straightforward. So it was more relatable that way. So it was the combination between the simplicity and the depth of the emotions, the simplicity of the lyrics, the depth of the emotions, and the simplicity of the composition and the instrument that really made this song such a great one for me. It was painful, but it was painfully beautiful. So check him out, Rico Blanco. He's written a lot of great songs in the Philippines. Some of them were actually written in English, but this one, I think, is one of my favorites that he has ever written, and it's in Filipino. But okay, thanks.